Hey everybody, Andrew here from AirDev with another episode of Demystifying Tech. Every week we take a different tech topic or term and we break it down using a whiteboard. This week's topic is binary. So I don't know if you've ever seen somebody wearing this shirt before. It says there are 10 types of people, those who know binary and those who don't. If you don't know binary, you don't get the joke. So we're going to walk you through what binary is and why computers like it so much, and then we'll come back to this at the end and you'll be in on the joke. So binary is not actually a secret code. It's just a different way to express numbers. So the normal way we write numbers is like this. This is what we call the decimal system. It's what we call a base 10, which means that there are 10 different symbols, 0 through 9, to use to express numbers. When we exhaust them all in counting, then we have to add a new digit, which is why we put the 1 and the 0 next to each other. After that, we continue counting, 11, 12, etc., until we get to 99. Once again, we've used all the possible combinations of two different symbols together. We have to go to a third digit and write 100. Binary works exactly the same way, except for you're only working with two symbols, the 0 and the 1. So you start the same way as you do with the decimal system, 0, 1. But after that, you've already used all of your symbols, so you have to add a digit. So you write the number 2 as a 1 followed by a 0. Then you're back on track with 11, and then right away again, you've exhausted all the combinations of two different digits, so you have to go to a third. 4 is expressed as 100. Now you've got 101, 110, 111. Once again, you get to a dead end, you have to add another digit. So 8 is 1000. And 1001 and 1010. Total coincidence that 10 is 1010. But you learn to appreciate that kind of stuff. So everything in a computer is expressed in these zeros and ones. And as you can tell, in just counting to the number 10, you already are dealing with four different digits. And so the digits can be very long. You get these very long strings of ones and zeros. But the computer knows how to turn these ones and zeros into everything from numbers to letters, symbols, commands like turn on your computer, boot up Gmail, show that cat video. Everything boils down to these ones and zeros. So why does a computer do ones and zeros? Why can't it do this base 10? Well, the reason is a computer at the very core level is just a circuit board. It's a bunch of these little circuits that can turn on or off. And the way they turn on or off is just by being open, where they don't have a current flowing through them, or closed, where the current can flow through. And so there is no middle ground. There's no 1 through 9. There's just open or closed. And so at a very physical level, the computer needs to express everything it knows in just open or closed, off or on. And so it's really just a practical matter why we use ones and zeros, but it's okay because we can translate them into everything that the computer needs to know. But what's the problem? The problem is, I don't like writing tons and tons of ones and zeros. It gets confusing to me. It's too long. So we need to have different ways for humans to be able to interface with these ones and zeros. Take an example. Let's say I've got my beautiful AirDev logo, and it's this really nice, it's called Hemlock Blue. It's just gorgeous. And I want to tell the computer, make everything this beautiful blue. The problem is the binary for the blue that I want is this. It's all of these ones and zeros. I don't want to have to remember that. I want it to just be a few digits to represent my color. And so, for example, what we do often in colors is we use the hexadecimal system. You've probably seen hex codes representing different colors. Now, the hexadecimal system is not base 2, it's not base 10, it's actually base 16. So you have digits 0 through 9 followed by A through F before you have to start adding another digit. And the convenient thing about hexadecimal is that 16 is actually 2 to the 4th power, and so it maps very well to this base 2. The fact that it's 2 to the 4th power means that every 4 binary digits maps exactly to one digit in the hexadecimal system. So for example, the first part of my blue for AirDev is 0100. If we look that up over here, that corresponds to 4 in binary. The first digit in my color for AirDev is 4. This is 1, these 4 are 8, these 4 are 3, D, and 7. And so the hexadecimal system is an easy way to translate binary into something that we can work with, and I can remember this color, or at least try to. And it's a good way to interface between a computer and a human. And there are all sorts of other ways that we map from computer language to our language so that we can interface with the computers that we know and love. So coming back to the t-shirt, I hope you get this now. I hope you're in that first group of people who get binary. If you want more, go to airdev.co or airdev.co/blog. Until next time, thanks.